video series is to accompany the Cisco Netacad IT Essentials 7.0 course. This video is Chapter 9, Virtualization and Cloud Computing. In Chapter 9, we're going to look at virtualization, installing a virtual machine on a computer, explaining server virtualization and cloud computing, describing the uses of the cloud, and explaining characteristics of public, private, hybrid, and community cloud computing. Virtualization. Virtualization enables a single computer to host a multiple independent virtual computers called virtual machines, or VMs. They share the host computer hardware. Virtualization software separates the actual physical hardware from the VM instances, and an image of VM can be saved as a file and then be restarted when required. Now, cloud computing separates these applications from the hardware, its services provided such as Amazon Web Services or Azure Web Services, and they manage the cloud infrastructure. And virtualization is the foundation which supports cloud computing. Now, with traditional server deployment, organizations delivered applications and services using dedicated servers. These dedicated servers were equipped with large amounts of RAM, powerful CPUs, and lots of storage devices. The disadvantage was you had a lot of wasted resources, you had a single points of failure, and you had what we call server sprawl. With server virtualization, you have a lot of advantages, such as idle resources to reduce the number of servers required. A program called Hypervisor is used to manage the computer resources and various VMs, and it provides VMs access to the hardware and the physical machines, such as CPUs, memory, disk controllers, and NICs. And each VM runs a complete and separate operating system. Some of the advantages of server virtualization: you have better use of resources, less space is required, less energy is consumed, you have a reduced cost, you have faster server provisioning, you maximize your server uptime, improve disaster recovery, and also it does give support for legacy systems. Now, client-side virtualization enables users to run VMs on their local computer. It allows users to test new operating systems, software, and to run older software. For example, on my personal computer, I've got a copy of Windows 7, a couple of copies of Windows 10, three or four different distributions of Linux that I run on there. I've been able to run Mac OS on there, and Android, and a Chromebook on my virtual machine on my local computer. So local virtualization or client-side virtualization allows for a wide range of operating systems to be run. You have a host computer, that's the physical computer controlled by the user. You have a host operating system, that's the operating system of the host computer. And then you have all your guest OSs. Those are the operating systems that are running on the VMs. You have type 1 and type 2 hypervisors. Type 1 is native. It's typically used with server virtualization. For example, they're used in data centers and cloud computing. And then you have, they run directly on the hardware of a host, and they manage the allocation of system resources to the VMs. And type 1 hypervisors include VMware, vSphere, ESXi, Xen, and Oracle VM Server. Type 2 hypervisors are hosted, and they're commonly used with client-side virtualization. Type 2 hypervisors work with the host computer to create and use multiple VMs, and these include VMware Workstation, Windows Hyper-V, and Oracle VirtualBox. Now, for virtual machine requirements, you have to have a host OS, Windows 10 Pro or Windows Server, is usually the minimum, although I have ran Windows 7. I've run some of the older VMs on Windows 7 and Windows 8. The processor needs to be a 64-bit with second level address translation. The BIOS, your memory, and your hard disk space. And I'm going to say here, for your hard disk space, you're going to need to have at least enough hard drive space to run each of your main operating system and then each one of your guest operating systems. For Windows 8, you need the minimum for Windows 8, at least 15 gig for each OS, although I've ran with smaller on some of the Linux versions. And then for Windows 7, you need at least 2 gig of memory and at least 15 gig, although I would say you need much more than 2 gigabits of memory. Cloud computing. So cloud computing provides users with on-demand delivery of computing services on the internet. Cloud computing services are owned and hosted by the service provider. Most of us already use some type of cloud service when we use social media, access to online music libraries, use of online storage for saved photos. Organizations typically pay cloud providers a usage fee based on the user access and usage of services. Cloud services are going to fall into three categories. Cloud service providers can provide these, such as software as a service. And I'm just going to make a real quick comment here that you do need to know these three types. These are going to be on exams. But you need to know software as a service, SaaS, platform as a service, and infrastructure as a service. And cloud services providers have extended the IaaS model to also provide IT as a service. So you also have ITaaS. Some of the characteristics of cloud computing: it's on demand or self-service. It can be rapid, or it says elasticity here, but you can do expansion quickly. You can have resource pooling. You can do measured and metered services, and you can have broad network access.